and tell you the Lord has brought me a mighty long way. Is there a witness in here? Yeah! And I know I'm being blessed. Good evening, St. James. I'm through here now. I'll never stop giving my testimony. And I won't let Satan convince me that I shouldn't testify even in my own situation. Is there a witness in here? The motives are not only the testifying of God's people, but the trusting of God's plan. Yeah, you heard about the patience of Job, haven't you? Good God Almighty. Job could have said to Hazelhurst with it. Job could have said, I'm through with it. Because the Bible said it was Job while his children was having a party. It was Job outside praying. Is there a witness in here? His wife, the children's mama, was serving the children in their party. It was Job that was outside, praying and talking to God. Is there a witness in here? But you know what happened on you? Hey, Job, I got something I need to tell you. What you want to tell? Hey, I was out in the field some folks came while I was watching your herd, and all the herdsmen there, River McGee, was all killed, and all the herds gone. They took every hog, they took every sheep, they took every goat, they took every cow, and they took every horse, everything on four legs that belonged to you. They took it, left me here to tell the story, Job, what are you gonna do? And before that one could finish speaking, another one, hey, Job, wait a minute, Job, I got some news for you. Good God, Job, you know we was out there in the fields working your crop. I don't know what happened. Seemed like it just come out of nowhere. Lightning came, struck the ground. I don't know how it started. I don't know whether somebody was playing with fire, but all your crop that was almost mature has all been burned up. And it was some of us trying to fight the fire, but we couldn't win. All of them got burned up. And it left me here to tell the story. Job, what you gonna do? And before that and got through speaking, here come another one. Job! Wait a minute, Job. I got some bad news for you. Job! I was up near the house. As a matter of fact, I was in the house with all your children was in there with a feast. And something happened. Wind came out of nowhere. Good God Almighty. And all four corners of your house gave way, and everybody in the house died, and all your children are gone now, Job. Left me here to tell the story. Job, what you gonna do? Job says, the Lord give it No, he said, naked I came into the world, and naked I'm going to leave. He said, I came in here one way, I'm going to leave the same way I came. But he said, the Lord give it, and the Lord take it away. Blessed be the name of the Lord. And the Bible says, Job sinned not, not charged God foolishly. What a mighty testimony. Good God Almighty. Job made his way up by his own house, set in a pile of ash, because boils that broke out all over his body. Good God Almighty. Actually, Reverend McGee, he was already sitting there. Good God Almighty. For 3 days, taking and scraping them sores off of him, trying to open up all that stuff. Pus, blood, scabs all over his body. He just sat there in the ash pile. You know Satan will try to do some things like that to you. No matter how God's been to you, he'll have you sitting on a pile of trash. Is there a witness in here? Friends that already showed up, sitting there looking at Job. His wife came out, looked at him, looked at his friends, looked back at him and said, Job, why don't you curse your God and die? He said, go on in the house, woman. You don't talk like my wife. I'm through here, St. James. But you know what Job says? Though he slay me, yet will I trust him. Actually, he says, I don't know the plan he has for me in my life, but he's allowing me to go through all of this. It's got to be a purpose. Sometimes God will allow you to go through some things. Good God Almighty. And he's working some plans out in your life. He's saying, I got to fix on you because something bigger is coming, and then I got to see what you gonna do when you go through your problems. Are you gonna praise me? Are you gonna play me? Good God Almighty. But Job said in his story, God will give you double for your trouble. Can't you see, Job? I've been through the storm and rain, but I'm still standing. Come through here now. Is there anybody in here? You know that you've been persevering under your pressure, and God has brought you out. If you're a witness in here, you ought to stand for me. Let me see where you are. I got a testimony, Reverend. He's done it for me. Good God Almighty. Is anybody in here? Can you say the devil had me by the neck, and God, good God Almighty, took me out of Satan's hands, stood me up on my trouble, and look at me now. My friends said I wasn't going to make it, but look at me, I'm still standing. Is there anybody in here who know you could have gave up, but it was God that did it? If you're a witness in here, you ought not be ashamed to let somebody know what he done for you. Would you agree with me? Say yes. Say yes. Say yes. Say yes. Yeah. Yeah. You wonder why I preach so hard. I've been asked that a million times. Why you preach so hard, Reverend? And I tell him, you don't know what he done for me. I should have been dead a long time ago, but God spared my life. I got to tell it everywhere I go. He's been good. Is there anybody in here? And he's been good to you. You ought to pray with me here and praise his name. Say yes. Yeah. Yeah. all right. I know he's all right. I know he's all right.